Tuesday, April 17th, 2018, and it's time to go work on music.
Excellent!
It's been a fantastic day. I'm in a really good place and excited for productive sessions as usual. Definitely getting into a better groove with my new sleep schedule. I knocked things down to 6 hours a night, and that was definitely a little painful, so I bumped it back up to 7.5 hours yesterday and today, and it feels way better. Most people tend to sleep, as far as I know, in 90-minute cycles, so moving things around by about an hour and a half tends to be a good metric to use, because then you're closer to waking consciousness when you get out of bed, which just helps the overall system stay balanced, as far as I understand it. I'm learning a lot about sleep right now, which is really fascinating. So I'm gonna do like maybe a week of 7.5 hours, and then maybe a little catching up and extra sleep on the weekends, kind of see where that leaves me, and then if I want to push it further again, not back to six again, then I will. But for now, this gives me about an hour and a half to 2 hours a day to work on music, which is just so much better than 30 minutes. I mean, it's really hard for me to feel like I got what I wanted out of the day, which is a 30-minute session. So I'm just optimizing for being maybe a little more sleepy at some points during the day, taking some naps, and then maybe being just a sensation of a little more fatigue, but like it hasn't really degraded my performance in any of the places that I'm trying to perform right now. And I'm not doing any heavy-duty tracking at the moment. I'll kind of ease into that. So physically, there isn't a crazy demand on my body, and a lot of this training I'm doing for my new gig is like sitting in a chair, you know, just sitting and like working more with my mind. So I'll let you guys know how this experiment evolves, but I think I found a good balance point right now where I'm sort of like one step ahead of where I was a couple weeks ago, but potentially, you know, not like at the ultimate top level yet, which I'm okay with right now. So as far as what I'm going to do today with my time, I'm going to hit some online classes, update you guys with what I'm doing there, going to hit a quick guitar practice and share my progress, and then going to try to make the first steps of setting up these new stands. This stand that I've got right here was very easy to assemble. I think the other stands I got might be a little more intricate, depending on how they shipped, and I read online that sometimes you need some extra parts. So I just want to open those up and then get those parts ordered if I do need them. But outside of that, that's probably going to be the whole session today, just making progress on getting the studio set up so that I can have great monitoring, so that I can get deeper into finishing this record and getting the sonics just insanely, ridiculously powerful and beautiful and amazing. That's the goal. So I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Let me know if you have any thoughts or questions as we go, and I'll update you guys at the end of the video with what I accomplished. Let's go!
Basically tell stories.
All right, great session. Just amazing to have some bandwidth to work with. Honestly, it's been a while. And also, good to have a plan. I'm starting to get back into using my goal journal on a regular basis and focusing on what are the things that are going to move me closer to my vision. And got to the online class, it's been great. Got to the online class front, got a few notes about lyric writing from the Art of Music Production class on Coursera. And using sensory language is huge, because that really triggers a somatic response in people and gets them into the zone. You know, think of something like a really good beat or a really good groove, triggers that kind of like, ooh, yeah. You can think the same thing with a lyric, where it's like, I felt the sand sifting through my hands on the beach of the promised land. You know, it's like, not the freshest rhyme. But, you know, it's something physical, and like, you can go even further, like, the grains of sand scraped my hand, you know, leaving nothing but, you know, the best laid plans, I don't know. You know, it's like taking something and bringing the listener into the song with imagery, sensory perception, and, you know, sight, smell, anything that would trigger a somatic response. The other note was making sure you're telling a story in your song, and that could be as simple as beginning, middle, end with the lyric story, or it could be as intricate as you want it to be, or it could be just vignettes, like Paul Simon Graceland style. So it's such a good class, guys. I mean, it's free, it's not that intense, and it's packed with really, really good stuff, so I strongly recommend getting into that if it's interesting to you. And then I just got a great guitar practice in, and just didn't rush it, you know, just gave myself plenty of time to explore the studio space. And just kind of let some feeling and emotion and just essence flow. Because that's I think, been one of the main things that I've been missing is just that soul contact on a daily basis. So that's where I'm at today. You know, maybe it's not ideal. Oh, I dragged the new acoustic treatments in here, and I'll start getting those set up tonight and tomorrow. Appreciate you guys for tuning in. Hope you guys are out there grinding toward your goals, enjoying the process. That's what I'm out here doing. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for more. Can't wait.